episode of Federal Engineers HQ. Today we have with us again our amazing engineers, little engineers, Mia, Ishita, and Pragna. And we have with us our resident engineer, Ankur Ankur, and I'm Vishal. Welcome to this week's episode. And this week's episode is fun. Do you know why, guys?
Because we're going to fix something.
Instead
of just opening to see what it is.
Beautifully said. Great. So now, today, we have a project. So we will fix a light. What is it? It's a lamp.
You guys have a question? Anybody has a question?
And what I noticed is that all video has the word engineer in it, and engineers fix things.
Beautiful. So that's a good point. So it's the video, the channel is called Little Engineers, and engineers fix things. So now, let's get going and let's see what we're going to do with this.
Yep.
All right.
Yes, Pratna.
How does electricity go into the lamp?
So we'll see very soon. That's a very good question. So let's guess.
All right. So let's see. How do we open this? Does anybody see any spots?
Yeah,
anything
else? There.
Okay, very good. So we see all the screws, we open them.
Yeah.
Let's start with that, okay?
Yes.
So now, this is a special mirror. You know why this is a special mirror?
No.
Because it lights up?
Yes. It lights up and it also does two things. It lights up and...
So is this coming in this guy?
Alright, so there are two things. There are two sides of the mirror. One is the flat side.
Oh yeah, and one makes your face get bigger.
Yes.
And one is a kind of like
this
bold
one.
Side.
It's a funky mirror.
And you know what this side is called?
A bowl or something?
It's called concave. It's called a concave mirror.
Concave mirror?
Yes, because you see it goes like this.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, because it makes things look bigger.
Yeah, so imagine, what is this? There's a cave, you know this is like a cave, right?
Yeah.
This is like a cave. Anybody sees like this is a cave, right?
Yeah.
So think of it. This is a cave shape.
And
it
also looks like a cobra's hood.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
That's good.
Yes, and they're doing some amazing job, and if you have that program locally, go and join it.
I go to that program.
Yes, we
they're
have
not our sponsors.
One of the little engineers, she goes to that. And you know
yeah.
She's really smart.
Okay,
yeah.
So guys, now you're paying attention.
Look at this now.
So there's a wire going into the mirror, and there are two parts of it. There's one part. Do you see what these things are? What is this?
No.
Doesn't even want to make a guess what this is?
I know.
What is it?
They like are holding up the pads.
Yeah, but
pads.
What are these pads? Anybody wants to make a guess what these pads are? What is it?
They hold the electricity and let them go when the light gets on?
No, they sometimes you call them lead weights. So the way is because the mirror is heavy, right? And you want to put a lot of weight at the bottom so that the mirror doesn't go sideways, right? If you have a lot of weight at the bottom,
then
it doesn't go sideways.
It'll stay down.
Yeah, it keeps this, what we call the center of gravity down. So the example is very simple, right? So we'll put this down so it doesn't fall. So look, if this was a screwdriver, if we try to balance it like this, see how easy it's like falling down, you see?
Yeah.
Right?
But if we put that pad at the bottom, it won't do that.
See, now the more weight is at the bottom, and then it doesn't fall as easily. Because the more weight is at the bottom. So the same way, these are the lead pads, so they have more weight at the bottom. It doesn't let the mirror fall.
The pads have like some kind of energy in them that could do it.
Yeah.
That's what I think.
So it also has something other than that. Do you see this
mirror?
Box?
Anybody
sees this box?
It has batteries.
Oh, do you know what this box does?
What?
Do you see?
Can I see?
Yeah. If you read it closely, we'll put it here on the mirror. It says touch light control. Do you know what that means?
No.
It has a what we call a touch sensor. So the way this mirror works is when electricity comes in, there's no switch. Do you guys see any switch?
No.
No, right? Usually when we open things, remember we used to have like a switch, on-off switch. Remember?
Yeah.
This doesn't have
even
one.
On the hammock, so they have
down. Yes, but in this case you don't see any switch, right? So the way this works is there's a touch sensor that's inside it, and then when you all you do is when you touch the mirror and it turns on.
What?
Yes.
Yeah, because when I was like, first I looked in it and there's no light, and that's I actually touched here, and then it just came on.
That's a good point.
And I was little, I used to see that.
So I think one thing that came into talk is sensor. So should we talk about sensor?
What's a sensor?
Yes, what is a sensor?
A sensor is like a... So let's say this table was a whole sensor. So when I touched it,
mm-hmm.
the sensor would like do something.
That's a
or make something
beautifully said. I think I love it. I think it's a good job. So yes, Pragna.
It's almost like if... Well, like there's a rose and we do it. We use a sense of smell to smell how the rose smells like sweet.
Beautiful.
Or,
I think that's a beautiful.
That was not that kind.
That's a sensor, but
that's also a one kind of sign.
Yeah.
Sensor. So sensors sense things. So technically, she's right.
Oh yeah, they see. Okay.
If you
does
see somebody,
know
okay.
what all the senses
okay,
are.
Okay, what is this thing?
Yes.
And if this this so of the mirror can sense.
Uncle has a point.
Alright, so does anybody know what your senses, what are the senses? Okay.
So the senses in the mirror is when you touch it.
No, but sensor, how many senses do we have?
Five? Eyes.
Which are those senses?
Eyes.
Mm-hmm. So
ears.
Seeing is one of them. Hearing is one of the senses.
And nose.
Nose is smelling.
Smelling.
And then also touch is a sensor, right? When I touch you, you feel, right? If your hand is cold, you feel cold. If your hand is warm, you feel warm, right? That's also one of the senses. So seeing, sight, smell, all those are good answers. So they are all senses. So what this one is, this is a touch sensor, right? So the mirror cannot see you. This doesn't have the seeing sensor or the smell sensor. It has the touch one. So when you touch it, it knows that, you just touched me. So that means you are asking me to turn on. So the circuit in the sensor, what happens is there's a circuit inside the sensor. When you touch it, it completes the circuit and then electricity goes into the light.
Yeah.
Right?
Wait, and this part, only that part, the round part, the part?
Yes.
This part lights up.
That's
yeah.
true.
I just wanted to tell that.
Now let's open...
Let's see what
else. But I know why it lights up.
Yes.
So,
Press it. Press it and not touch the bench and then we can talk. Yes.
But
look. Issue. We'll be sitting. It's a safety thing, right?
Alright, guys.
So, if you can't see it so good, the light will just.
See.
Alright,
wow.
So guys, this is very important, right? So now, see, there was this sensor, and this is what I was telling. Does anybody want, you guys want to take a look? You can take a look. Pass it around, please. Me after you pass, if you look at it, pass it around next to Ishita.
Now Ishita can see.
Ishita, you want to read what it says?
Touch light control.
Yes, so touch. It's a touch sensor, right? Okay.
So when you touch it, then it tells the mirror, you want me to turn on. So
yeah.
Then
it will light control.
Yeah, it says touch to light control. So Parikya, you want to pass me back? So here's the other important part. In addition to touch to light control, it also has a little diagram. Did you guys see the little diagram? What I'll do is I'll draw the little diagram on our diagram here.
This is mine.
So today we have our little engineer pad that we'll use.
Right.
So I think we're going to sit. No standing.
So everybody remembers that things come in from the electricity, right? So we have a positive and a negative. So this is your wire coming in, right? The wire brings in and it has a positive and then a negative, right? Both of them go in. And then the way this circuit, it shows right here on the circuit is that it shows you that it's an AC power circuit. But then it also shows this, that there is a sensor. This is the sensor. And then there is a light. There's a light bulb. We'll draw a light bulb here, right? So imagine this is your light bulb, right?
Yeah.
And then it completes the sensor like this.
That's
now,
actually, so Ankur did a very, very good thing here. So do you know what Ankur is doing right now?
What?
He's drawing a circuit diagram. So do you know what a circuit diagram is?
No.
This is a circuit
diagram is it is an easy way to understand what's going on inside.
Yeah.
It's a diagram of a circle?
Yeah.
Yes, beautifully said. I think there's an I missing somewhere.
It's
UIT. So that
yeah.
guy.
Yeah.
So this is the quick way to understand. Now you exactly know what to expect in this by looking at a circuit diagram.
Alright, now, so the what a diagram does, the circuit does is, remember everybody, like, think of it as like water. Remember, it's coming in and it's trying to go all the way, remember?
Yeah.
And then go
it's
back, right?
Circuit.
Yeah, so
yes.
Like what happens is when, Nia, pay attention, off
the
work page, please. Okay, so what happens is when electricity comes in, it's trying to go finish this circuit, right?
Yeah.
But what is this? It's stopping. It's
the bridge.
It's the bridge. It's saying, oh, you can't go further. And what happens is when you touch it, the touch sensor, you complete the circuit and then electricity can go and then all the way back and the light goes.
Let's
go. Glows.
On.
Yeah.
Wait, you mean the sensor could just see if it's electricity or not?
So the electricity is there. Sensor is just on off switch. So you do on and off, right?
Yeah.
So in this one,
excuse me.
You, the moment you touch it, it says it. That's the on switch now.
Excuse
sensor
me.
Says hey, you're touching
yeah.
something. Then
yeah.
on it.
What are these blue
yes.
things?
Okay, that's good. That's good questions.
Is it like when we touch something then? And then it knows like, oh, now we have to make the
yeah,
light go on
right,
and then it
right.
Yeah, so imagine
that's
this
right.
was a gap, remember? If think of it like this. Let's say if this was a, electricity came in and it wants to go here, but it doesn't, it can go, right? Because there's a gap. Imagine if you put your thumb like this, now electricity can say, oh, I can go to this thumb and I can go ahead, right? It can use your thumb. So think it like that. It bridges the circuit. Now we'll show you the circuit here. There's a there are very important things here. So now, does anybody remember from your previous videos what is this called? The green thing?
A circuit board?
Very good.
Circuit board. Yes.
I don't know what a circuit board is.
So you're drawing. This is a circuit drawing, right?
Yeah.
This is a circuit drawing. If you draw it on a board, it's a circuit board.
Yeah.
What?
Usually whenever we have electronics, because you don't want all these wires to be loose, what circuit board is, it creates a board which you can use to draw your circuit and it doesn't move all the time. So you see the important parts of a circuit board is it has this board and then it's also, you see those metallic lines in there?
Yeah.
They're like
you
wires.
See,
yeah, can I say something?
Do you see those?
But what are those little spikes?
You see those things?
Yeah. The spikes?
No, the spikes we will talk about, but do you
all
see
the lines? All the lines.
All the lines.
Yeah,
lines.
I see
connecting
them.
The silver
oh,
ones.
Yeah, the lines. They look, some of them look like rocks.
So yeah, so those
oh,
lines,
yeah. those are like cables, wires.
Yeah, think of those lines like these things.
Wires.
Those are the same lines like we drew. So
it's this thing. It's almost like this thing drawn into a small circuit.
Can
yeah.
I see that?
Yeah, right here.
Right.
So these lines. So instead of using these cables, you draw it with a metal.
Now let's answer Ishita's question. Ishita, you want to know what these spikes are, right?
Yeah.
So if you what these spikes are, these are edges of all these components. So in addition to putting these lines, we also have all these components on the circuit. You know what these components are?
Yeah.
So let's talk about them. Yep.
Wait, I just saw two things that look like
things.
A battery.
These like hold it for a little while and it goes to the next one, hold it for a little while, and then it gets to travel around the whole
no,
thing.
No. So let's pay attention, Mia, okay? Mia, these are very important components. This component, the one with, do you see the little cylindrical thing with lines on it?
Yeah.
You see this component?
Okay.
Yeah.
Wait,
this is called a resistor.
Resistor.
What does a resistor do? Anybody remember from the past what it does? Resistor thinks of it, it creates resistance. It doesn't let electricity go super fast. Zoom. It says, electricity, you need to slow down. It maintains control by putting some resistance, right? Electricity, remember that we were giving that example? If it was like flat, you'll go super fast. And if it was like little bit less flat, you'll go a little bit slow. And if it was really, really flat, you'd go a little bit more slow. That's what resistance
is.
Right.
Like that, you would go
like
just walking.
In my circuit thing, like Pokemon gave me that circuit, that circuit toy.
Snap
circuit. She gave me snap circuit.
Mm-hmm.
And that music thing has a resistance thing.
Yes.
So the music goes up too fast and you won't even hear.
Yes. So,
yeah.
Good job.
Yes, no, that's no. Very good. So if we didn't have resistors in the circuits, it's then electricity will go super duper fast. And we try to slow it down because we want to do different things at different times. So all those resistance will help you do that, right? And then there are these other big black things like little bit cylinders. Do you guys see?
No,
it looks like batteries to me.
Yes. So it does something close to what a battery does. First, what you know what it's called? Pragna, you know what's called?
No, I just...
You have a question?
Yeah.
What is your question?
What's
the question?
Like, if someone's running around very fast in the department,
mm-hmm.
then their parents say, slow down a little bit, slow down.
It's kind of like
so what's the question? Do you have a question, Pragna?
Dad, what are these two blue things?
Yeah, so we'll come back to them as well. So first we were talking about the black things, right?
Yeah.
They look like batteries. They are called capacitors.
Capacitors?
And I think we'll discuss that later. I think that's later on we'll use that. We'll once we do something that is
called capacitors. Oh, I remember capacitors from the old one. Like they hold their electricity a little and they go straight to the
That's why they're called capacitors, because they hold the electricity and they hold the charge.
Yeah.
So there's a positive charge plate, there's a negative charge, they hold the charge there. So it's almost like a battery.
It's a very quick battery.
So what holds positive ones and what holds negative?
Yes.
Now let's move on.
So now, and then there are also these, you see that little spider kind of thing? It has like the four legs on this side and the four legs on the other side.
Yeah.
Do you guys see this?
I can't see it so well.
You see that little black thing? It has like four legs on this side.
Oh, yeah, this must be a magnet.
No, it's not a magnet. Do you know what it is?
No.
You know what this is called? This is the brain of the circuit.
The brain?
Yeah, it controls the entire circuit.
It controls the whole thing?
Yeah.
It makes the circuit very smart.
Yeah. So this is the part which tells the entire circuit. It's called an IC. It tells the entire circuit what to do. It tells the electricity, okay, electricity, you are going this way. This tells the electricity to slow down or fast.
Don't do that, do that.
It's the brain of the circuit.
Oh, so actually, inside it actually makes a voice, but you cannot hear that voice because it's like too hot.
Yeah.
And I have a question for Uncle.
Like fast.
So what is the thing that we want to do with this lamp? What is wrong?
Yeah.
We have not discussed that.
So do you see anything wrong so far?
We need to know what's wrong before we can fix it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Engineers, what do you think?
So
we need to know, right? Mia?
Yeah. So now let's try to answer Uncle Michelle's question. So in order to figure out what's wrong, we usually have to start opening it up and then see, maybe we see something wrong. So we
I know.
So hold on. Let's wait a little bit. So electricity is coming in from here. It went into our circuit here. But do you see anything wrong with the circuit? Is there anything like broken or
done?
Something broken. What is broken? You see anything?
On this side?
Mm-hmm.
That thing is tilted and then...
Yeah, no, I don't think it's broken here, Mia. Usually,
so how do we know something is not well?
If something
looks not very obvious, so if suppose if you are sick, right, so you look tired, then we know something is wrong.
Mm-hmm.
If I say, Shita, let's play, and you say, no, uncle, I can't play, I'm very tired,
mm-hmm.
right, and that means you're not okay. In the circuit, we may see something which is, maybe something is dark, something is burned.
Yes.
Something is broken. Something is not connected, and it looks like it should be connected.
Yes.
That's how we figure out something is wrong.
So Uncle Shah made a very good point. If we opened this up and we saw like one of these legs was broken, or one of these IC legs was broken, or resistant legs was broken, or the capacitor leg was broken, or if they were burnt, like they would be dark, you will see that okay, it got burnt. Then we will know it's broken. But now we don't see anything like that, right? Or if we turn this around and we see one of these, rather than that it's connected, it's loose, but it's broken and the solder has come out.
Can I see?
Yeah.
I think I have a problem.
Yeah.
Now these two are like connected. They look white and black.
Yeah.
So unless you see a black, so it's difficult. Can you go a bit back?
Wait.
Because we don't want to touch
the
workbench.
Wait, that one got burned, maybe.
Because we have Uncle has tools which might hurt us. We have to be stay safe.
So now since nothing is broken here, now we go to the next part. So electricity comes in from here, and then it, the circuit, it looks like it's doing its job, and then it's sending the electricity up this wire into through this thing into the mirror. So now maybe we'll open the mirror and try to, do you guys see it? Can you guys see that electricity is coming in through these wires, and then it's going to the circuit, and the circuit is telling the electricity to go up these wires. Mia, do you see these wires?
Even
oh,
the,
yeah, I can't see that.
The white, you see the white wires?
So it comes from the red or yellow wire.
And then it goes in.
Then it goes, then it says it goes to the circuit, and then it goes in the white wire.
Yes. So now we have to see where the white wire goes, and maybe when we open up this thing, and we'll see where the white wire goes. Okay.
Whoa! I want to see.
No, everyone, wait!
All right, guys.
Now let's
move
focus.
Your hands back, please.
Now let's focus back on the circuit.
Now this part is very sensitive part, so you have to. Everybody has to be very careful, okay? So you have to keep your hands back.
Okay.
Oh, we can't see it.
So there's a bulb in here. First, we open up the bulb so we don't damage it.
We don't destroy it, guys.
So now, hold on.
No. We don't have to touch it. It's very sensitive.
So it's very sensitive bulb.
It looks like okay.
It looks a little bit shaky. So that might be the reason that Ruchi and D. But alright, you want to see it?
Yeah. Don't hold it. Look at the wires inside.
Does anything unusual look about?
Hey, can I see it?
Yeah.
Oh, why? Hey, I see something kind of weird.
No, so
wait,
I think.
A silver
so what?
Going
what
are, all around.
So guys, what are we looking for in the bulb? Is do we see any wire inside the bulb that snapped?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Look at that. No, so look very carefully. You have to find us a wire that is snapped.
Wait, can I see it again?
I don't think the wire is tapped, but let's just look at the bulb visually first. What is the bulb supposed to be? Is it supposed to be absolutely clear, or is this supposed to be a little bit black?
It's absolutely clear.
Yes. Do you guys think this is absolutely clear, or do you think it's a little bit black?
A little black.
You guys see that, right? Yeah. I see that too. If you put it in, especially on a white background, we have brought back.
Yeah.
So see, if you put it on a white background,
it looks black.
You see a little bit black,
it looks
right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. So I think there might be something wrong with the bulb, but we'll test it, okay? And then we also
it's time for us to focus.
Now let's see
what's going on.
So see, what's supposed to happen is when this thing turns around, you see this thing's rotates
yeah.
a little bit.
Yeah.
So do we see anything loose here?
Oh, can I check? Maybe it's that.
Maybe it's a black thing because it was
kind of nice.
I don't think anything is loose here. So guys, I think we found the culprit. I think the culprit is
about the light bulb that it's a little black.
I think the
I have a question, Uncle. So we know the person whose lamp it is, she told us that once we tilt the lamp, then only lamp is closed.
Yeah.
So why would this bulb
let's
tilt?
Let's see. So that's a very good question by Uncle Vishal. So what happened is, I think what has happened is, all these bulbs, there are very tiny wires inside the bulb. You guys see those tiny wires?
Yeah.
See it? Ishita?
Yeah, that looks cool.
Yeah. So I think what has happened is, that the tiny wires inside the bulb, one of the wires has tapped, but when the bulb tilts like this, it touches it. And then because it touches, it lights up. But when it moves away, the wire stops touching and then it goes down.
Oh.
I think that's the reason. See, and the reason I'm saying that is look, I'll tap the bulb a little bit. Do you see a wire that's shaky wire?
Oh, yeah.
You see it's moving?
I can't see it.
Yeah, so Mia, do you see when I tap it, do you see
the
wire?
Wait. The baby does a loose wire.
So you see there's a wire that
it's a loose
one. So when I'm supposed to do this, the wires are not supposed to move. So when I tap the bulb like this, it's supposed to, if everything was tight and not loose, then there shouldn't be any wire moving like this.
So we are seeing a snapped wire inside?
Yeah.
It's a loose wire.
It's a loose wire.
So, because I know these terms, these guys are they are very tiny, so they wiggle.
How do we get a bulb? Anybody know how do we know which bulb to buy when we go to the market?
To see if it looks the same small.
That's one point.
And if we tap it, it doesn't shake.
That's good. We don't want to buy a broken one. But there's also one very important thing when you're buying a bulb.
What?
You see those little numbers on the bulb?
Can I
play? No touching.
I think
because it's broken, we have to be careful. You see any numbers?
Can I read the numbers?
Yeah.
It says 120V.
So that's very good. So Mia just read these numbers. It says 120V and 20W. So 120V is for 120 volts. So
we'll discuss that. I think maybe in the next video. Yes.
Yeah. And then the other is the 20 is the watts. So there is a one thing called voltage and the other thing called wattage. So it's 120 volts and 20 watts. That's the bulb we have to buy.
What means power?
Strong.
How strong the bulb is. You know, some bulbs are like, if you lit it up, they're teeny tiny. They just don't make any light. Those are low watts. And if you just glow, some bulbs are like so, look at these lamps. They're so strong.
And
it's kind of hurting my eyes.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, it's also hurting my eyes.
So what is power? And the volt is the difference, is the electricity that this bulb can take.
Right.
All right, guys. I think we found our culprit. We replaced the bulb and hopefully the lamp will work.
So this is amazing. I think we did. So we got our first gate and we fixed it. We just found it.
We found the problem. That was going on inside.
So I think we found our culprit today. So we fixed it and we did a good job.
But we didn't fix it yet.
We need to buy the bulb.
But we need to go out in the market and buy the bulb.
We don't know how to fix it.
Yes. So now once we put the bulb back in, hopefully
It will work.
Okay. And if it won't, we'll see you on the part 2 of this video. And we hope there is no part 2 because we thought we fixed the lamp.
Yay!
So again, thank you so much everyone for watching this video. Yes, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you walked with us how to troubleshoot a lamp and see how we
again.
So you would have seen how this lamp works and how the sensor works. And how the touch sensor works, and we saw how the circuit board was not seeing any sign of damage, and then we saw the bulb, the filament was loose. So we'll go out in the market and get the bulb and get replaced. So thank you so much once again, do try these fun experiments at home with an adult and use all the precautions. Use all things
to. The heavy part. The rest of it is plastic.
Do and have fun with the family. Yes, Pragna.
And this is my last thing.
Why is the last thing? You're going somewhere?
She's
not going anywhere. Yes.
Watch this video with your friends and family, and try this video try to fix things or open things.
And do share your videos if you end up creating some interesting ones.
Don't forget our names again: Mia, Ishida, and Pragna.
And don't forget to share with this video if it's useful. Like us, subscribe us. Thank you so much. Bye bye.
It's a comment.
And
talk to
us. Sorry, we are fine.